Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So today we are going to write our first Svelte components. So, usually when I write a Svelte component, I will head over to the Svelte REPL. It's like a playground where you can write your components without having to worry about all the setup. You just write and then you take a look at the results. And if you're happy with it, you can even download the code and run it in your environment. So let's see. So let's head over to the REPL, which is svelte.dev/REPL. Or if you are in the svelte.dev website, you can come over here to the top right corner and click on the REPL button. And so here is this playground that I mentioned. You can play around with it, type something, and see the results immediately on the right. And you can download, as I said, which you can run your code. So we'll take a look at that later on. But first, let's zoom this up and let's start with our first component. So I'm going to name this first component, Svelte component. So first thing first, a Svelte component is written in one file, and the file extension is have to be end with .svelte, .svelte. So a Svelte component is a file that ends with a .svelte extension. And the syntax of what you're going to write in here is going to be similar as HTML. So a Svelte syntax is actually a superset of the HTML syntax. So if you're familiar with writing HTML, you can just write it over here. For example, I'm going to write H1, my first Svelte component. Whoops. And I'm going to have a few paragraphs. Let's see. Paragraphs. Hello world. And I can have style text like how you would in your HTML file where you can have style tag and style your elements as you like. So I'm going to make my H1 be color Rebecca purple. This is the purple color that Rebecca loves the most and Rebecca's favorite color. And you can change P tag to maybe a different font size. Font size 44 pixels, right? So you can add styles. You can have HTML just like you would in HTML, right? So you can add some attributes. So I'm going to come over here and say add an anchor tag. So link to my YouTube and then can add attributes just like how you would in HTML. So I'm come over here and say, okay, this is my YouTube channel. Hopefully you come up. Okay, this is my link to my YouTube channel. So you can click over here. So you can have href attributes and you can have children like you would in HTML. So let's see, let's come over here and have I'm gonna wrap all this within a div. Right, so you can have children, you can have attributes just like you would in HTML. And lastly, code, the logics for your components will be in a script tag. Right, so we will explore how you would write your logic for your components, but just for you know, anything within script tags will be like JavaScript. So you can have something like let's name equals to Li Hao. Right, this is JavaScript. You can write any JavaScript you like over here. So one thing you need to take note is that unlike HTML, you can have multiple styles tag, but in a Svelte component, you can only have one style tag, right? Only one, and that one is important, right? Same goes with script tag. You can only have one script tag or else you get a warning, an error, a build error, right? So that is it. Lastly, I'm gonna show you this. I'm gonna download this and gonna open it up. I'm gonna open it up. And let me to open up my code editor. So I'm using a VS Code over here, where I have, so this app.svelte is what we've written over just now. And to use this component in a setup that you would, right? This is a quick preview of how you would do is you would come over here in a min.js file and you would import your Svelte components and it will be a class. It will be a default export and you can use it where you choose where to mount your components. I will talk about this in more detail later on and even how to set up your environments, how to set up build settings, right? But this is just to let you know that your components will be in a .svelte file and you can import from anywhere and use it like a component, like a class, right? So that's it for this video. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you learned something or you're unclear of, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya. Bye-bye.